All right, and welcome back to the Monday Injury Report. I am your host, Nick Valletta, joined as always by Dr. Mark Casimiro. What's up, Mark?
What's going on, everyone? I'm a little tired because I watched WrestleMania last night. Can I just take the floor for a second? Vince McMahon, you can't go to 12:30. I'm an old man. I can't stay up that late. I have things to do. I can't do this, you know?
Yeah, you have work in the morning, and you literally worked last night because it was on from 5 to 12:30. That's almost a full work day.
That's ridiculous.
There's a lot of sports on this weekend. We had the Final Four, and we have the national title game set, Virginia versus Texas Tech. So that should be a good one. But actually, what we're going to talk about today are two Boston sports teams that are about to start the playoffs. So we have the Bruins and the Celtics. Celtics still have one game left, but Brad Stevens already said he's not really going to play the starters too much in that game to give them some rest because their seed is set. They're going in as the four seed. So the Bruins, they're going to be starting the first round of the playoffs against the Toronto Maple Leafs. We've got a couple injuries to talk about. Forward Sean Corrali, he's got a hand fracture. He's definitely not playing game one. Don Sweeney already said he'd be out for that one, but he could return before the end of the first round playoff series. So what are your thoughts on that, Mark?
Yeah, so I think he had a hand fracture, like you said. I mean, usually we're talking 6 to 8 weeks for full healing, you know, before you can get these guys back into some, you know, sports-specific activities, skating, obviously. You know, they can probably make him a little bit of a pad to go inside of his glove to give him a little bit of extra support. You know, obviously we all know that the playoffs in hockey are a little bit more physical in nature, and it definitely is a war of attrition. It's almost like a second season, or it is like a second season. So you worry about, you know, guys getting physical, slashing on the hands, kind of a re-injury, or if he takes a shot off the hand somehow, something like that. So we want to make sure that there's no risk that he's going to, you know, put his team in a bad predicament or a bad way. So he has to be pretty close to 100%, and they have to be sure that he'll be able to kind of withstand the rigors of a playoff game. So I'm not sure if he's going to make the entire run of the playoffs. You might see him need, you know, a game or here or there off to kind of let that hand rest and recover a little bit. You know, they're hockey players, though. So I don't know if anyone remembers a couple of years ago, Glenn Campbell broke his tibia and was able to finish the shift out there blocking shots and skating around. So they are wired differently than the rest of us, and it is the playoffs. So, you know, and Patrice Bergeron played last year or 2 years ago with a punctured lung. So these guys are nuts. So I'm not going to sit here and say that he's not going to be able to play in the playoffs. I think he'll play. I think the question is, how effective is he? And does he make it the entire length of the way? And I'm a little nervous that he's not going to be able to make it the entire playoff season, just because of how close that injury happened to the end of the season. And obviously the style of play for these playoffs, I think he's going to probably have to miss some time here and there. But hopefully they prove me wrong and he proves me wrong and he's ready to go.
Yeah, I mean, you have so many fans out there who say, like, oh, I mean, I don't watch hockey, but I'll watch playoff hockey because it's just it's like almost like another sport with how fast and how physical it is. All right, this is going to be a little bit of a revision to the Monday Injury Report right after we finish recording. We got the news that Kevin Miller is actually out for the rest of he's out for the playoffs for the Bruins with a fractured patella. So talk about that quick, Mark.
Yeah, so obviously something a little bit more serious than they were leading on to end the season. Fractured patella, which is your kneecap. So somewhat similar injury to what Kyrie Irving had last year, although maybe a little bit different since Kyrie Irving had a different history. Fractured patella, though, that's obviously going to be really important in any type of standing activity. Ice skating is a standing activity, Nick, if you were wondering. So,
okay,
it's going to be real challenging for him. The report I said is like, oh, there might be a chance he comes late in the playoff season. I think no, he's going to be out for the entire playoffs because of it, and hopefully he shouldn't have to miss any time at the beginning of next year, as long as everything kind of heals up the right way. But yeah, definitely a big blow. But if you look at the player's injury history, he definitely has a little bit of a history of injuries in the playoffs. So maybe this is good going into it. You know, you can't rely on him. Maybe you get some of the young guys a chance and they can kind of step up.
This will require a surgery?
Yeah, probably. I think he'll need some surgery to go in there. I mean, I think it depends on how big the fracture is, where it is, but more chances than not, they can't just let that heal on its own, him being an athlete. You know, they need to make sure that it's healing correctly. So, yeah, I think he'll need surgery to get it taken care of and make sure that it's healing properly. I don't think this is something that you probably just want to sit and wait, because if the athlete waits and then he's still not ready to go next, you know, preseason or at the beginning of the season, he's going to have to miss all of next year. So, yeah, definitely going to need surgery, in my opinion. We'll probably get more information of that coming out in the next couple weeks. But, yeah, kind of a big loss, but there's no way that he can be effective with that injury.
Well, Mark, I appreciate you, you know, popping back on so we could do a little, like I said, a little revision of the Monday injury report before we put it out to you guys, the audience. Now back to your regularly scheduled program.
Nice. Healthy.
All right, another team entering the playoffs, the Boston Celtics. Last night in their game, Marcus Smart goes down with what they're calling a strained oblique or an oblique contusion. He goes down, gets up, tries to tough it out. He takes one run down the court to the other end and collapses again and has to come out. It looked bad. What are your thoughts on an oblique contusion? How long can this injury last? Is he going to miss some significant time?
Yeah, so I watched the video on this. It was kind of a weird kind of play. So you can get like a what's called a hip pointer. So basically it's like a contusion of like the hip flexor muscle as it's kind of on the right on the bone there, and so that muscle kind of bangs up against the bone that causes like a little pocket of swelling, and then obviously that can cause a lot of pain. Usually those types of injuries, you're not at risk of causing more damage as you play. It's just really painful, and obviously with a sport like basketball, when you're running, you're changing direction, you're jumping, you know, the oblique muscles, those hip flexor muscles, all that's a very important area. So it is a little concerning. I you know, usually with an oblique or like a contusion or like an oblique strain, you know, you're looking at anywhere from 2 weeks on the mild end to 4 to 6 weeks on a more serious case. You know, obviously they don't have that kind of time. Marcus Smart is an important player for them, especially defensively. So I'm really up in the air. I don't think that he's going to be able to go for game one. I think that he's probably going to need to miss like the rest of this week, let that thing heal. Because I think the risk is you let him go out there for game one. If he aggravates that injury, now he's not coming back until late in the second round. Like, do you really want that? I think if you can kind of manage this in the first like week or two now, maybe get him back later in the first round, like game four, maybe, you know, when he's ready to go. And then that way he doesn't have to miss any time and you get him back right when you need him. So I think we'll have to, again, wait on more information. Obviously, you know, maybe he woke up this morning and felt really good and he doesn't need to miss that game, that first game of the playoffs. But I think with that oblique strain, that oblique kind of contusion, they're going to be smart to give him at least another week off. So I think he's going to probably miss those first two games in that first round playoff matchup. And then hopefully from there, he'll be good to go and that we don't see him re-aggravate that injury as he gets back on the floor. You know, same thing with hockey. The basketball season's very, very long. You see some of these guys take some time off towards the end of the season. But once the playoffs start, you know, they usually have to be really injured to kind of keep them off the court. And obviously Marcus Smart is a very – very tough competitor. He's going to want to be out on the court. So it will take a lot for him to kind of to be out of this game. But I do think if they're being smart, maybe take the first game or second game off. Like, let's make sure he's close to 100% before we get him back out in game action.
Yeah, I mean, I hold my breath every time Marcus Smart like pulls up for a three-pointer. But everything else that he does, I love. I love. He's just gritty. He's just he out hustles people. I mean, and he's not gonna back down from anybody. If somebody gives one of his teammates a cheap foul, he's the first one there to defend his teammate. And I think that's why he's really won over the Boston fans. They love him for that. And so I hope. I mean, they have that. Game tomorrow night against the Wizards that, like I said, the starters already aren't going to play. And so he's got some time there. And then, but then after that, the playoffs start. So I hope they send him at least the first two or three games and then see how they're doing. You know, if they've got like a 2-1 lead or something like that, then maybe see if they can wait till the second round. But if they have to, you know, bring him back. But I would hate for him to come back and get hurt and then miss more time. Well, Mark, that's all I got for you today. Go home, go to bed, rest up. I'm glad you enjoyed WrestleMania last night. Going to do a little teaser for next week. We might be doing a little a Game of Thrones injury report with a little warrior workout, a little recap. So you better watch it on Sunday night because it might be spoilers on Monday.
I like it.
Who knows? Mark and I might be dressed up. You never know. Well, Mark, thanks for joining us. Everybody out there, if you have any questions, make sure to leave them in the comments below. And we'll see you guys next Monday. Have a fun, safe week. Later, Mark.
Thanks, guys. Bye, Nick. Peace.
Later.